Hello everyone. Today I want to introduce you to Webdock. As you can see on the screen, Python Ready VPS Server. I know Amazon, AWS, GCP, Azure are all kind of very popular, but do you really want to have to learn everything about them and their billing strategies? One of the stumbling blocks when you sign up for AWS or GCP is you have to put in your credit card details, and you can set up alerts, but you're never quite sure if you're going to leave something running and potentially end up with a very large bill. So I never like that kind of thing. And I've also been looking for a fast, independent, eco hosting package, and I found this. I Googled for Python hosting, and I ended up at a referral site, and one thing led to another, and I found Webdock. One of the reasons I liked them was because the prices were good, they advertise great speed, Python and pip pre-installed. Now, I probably won't show it today, in fact I won't, but I've already set up my first server, and it's got Python 3.10, which is great because with my previous hosting that I've run for a couple of years, it's quite a cheap package running PHP and WordPress. It's advertised, or for 2 years I've struggled because it was advertised as having Python, and you go into cPanel and had Python 2.7, which was not great. So I think recently they've upgraded it, but it was still only Python 3.8, I think, when I ran it or logged in the other week. But this really is advertised as being Python ready. Performance guaranteed, awesome control panel, which I can vouch for, epic support. I've already been in communication with the staff at Webdock, and they are really good people. They respond really quickly. And you can either host or get your servers hosted from Europe or the US, so covering lots of bases there. It's like Linode and cPanel had a beautiful love child. So there's some good Trustpilot recommendations there. Webdock has my back. I'm running a small digital agency and hosts 80 plus client sites. They do lots of heavy lifting, semi-managed, but you throw anything at them and then they fix it. Honestly, I've tried like 5 different hosting companies, and today yours was the best. You have the most intuitive GUI and startup fastest. Yeah, so obviously you can come here. It's webdock.io. So not dog, doc, webdock. Get started for only $4.99. In fact, I believe there is a cheaper package, but to be honest, I think it's worth the extra to at least start with this package. I mean, that's £5. That's £60 a year, or less than £60 a year in English money. Intel Xeon, enterprise-grade redundant hardware, lots of threads and RAM for your VPS. You got a choice of the Intel, or you got AMD Ryzen. Amazing water-cooled, single-thread performance, less RAM for your VPS. North America is a location, data center in Montreal, Canada, or Helsinki, Finland. Again, that's probably going to be really eco because it's probably going to need less cooling than, say, somewhere in Mediterranean. So hardware, here we go. You've got all these options. So there's 6 different options of the SSD, SSD bit more, SSD byte, Pro, Plus, Premium. The $19.99 is meant to be popular. So let's just look at the first one. And for $4.99 a month, €4.99. Single core, 50 gigabyte SSD, 2.5 cores, 5 threads, 1 gigabit, unlimited traffic. If you look on Amazon or GCP, just these specs are, as soon as you start moving up through the specs on the, especially on the VM instances, you start really moving up in the price range. And the great thing about this is it's just $4.99. So next, What's the difference? So you go up to 10 gig of memory. This profile is suitable for most basic websites with low to medium levels of traffic. So how many people actually run the website with high levels of traffic? Probably the minority. If you imagine it like a bell curve, high traffic, probably only the top, maybe what, 10% of sites. 100 gig onboard SSD, 5 cores, 10 threads, at 1 gigabit port, that's great. So let me go up to suitable for most basic websites with medium levels of traffic. Okay, so if you're like a medium-sized business, which is good, you could have, you can read all this. I won't go through it and bore you all. So it's all here. This is a recommended profile for any website or app that needs to perform and deliver lots of page views. So if you're a business, then €20 a month, €240 a year, that's I think that's going to be well worth it. We'll never charge you additional fees for traffic on our unlimited traffic profiles if it is for legitimate and above board purposes. Yeah, so you don't start running DDoS or running hundreds of scrapy spiders or anything. If your profile has a traffic limit, we will charge you a fixed fee per terabyte overage. I'm not aware that you can read all the details anyway. You can change your server profile anytime instantly without downtime, and you can purchase additional projects, which is products even, such as add-on storage. All VPS servers get snapshots included for free. 5 automatically rotated snapshots, as well as 3 snapshots you can manage yourself. Ubuntu is a preferred operating system on Webdock servers. You can also deploy Alma Linux, CentOS, and Debian, but not Windows or any other OS. Why would you want to? Awesome control panel, Python ready, VPS, free SSL certificates. Sometimes you'll need to get charged extra for that, or you have to get upgrades. Right, this is a good bit. Python is pre-installed in our LAMP stacks. Our LAMP web server stacks have Python and pip pre-installed. Now you can proxy with Apache or Nginx to your Python server, or just set up your own Python stack if you want on a clean Ubuntu server. So going forward in a future video, we're going to look at deploying, creating and deploying a website in Django on this Python server, or on a server running Python, should we call it. Lots of free backups, scaling, babysit things for your server, DDoS protection, and it's carbon neutral. So what's not to like? Vertical scaling is when you add additional performance, so you could be going to a faster processor or whatever. So mature, highly secure, 99% compatibility, runs, fully supports Docker and LXD. So hopefully I've sparked your interest. There's going to be a affiliate site or link to get a discount in the comments of this video. In future videos, I'm going to look at deploying on the server with Python code, Django, Flask, FastAPI, etc. Also, I will be looking at the Python SDK. There's an SDK to do things with their servers. It's on GitHub. I'm going to download it. I'm going to experiment with it, write some scripts, test it out, and yeah, create a server in 2 minutes or less. I'm so excited because the last time I used something like this was maybe 10, 20 years ago, and yeah, everything was really clunky, bad GUI. Yeah, really clunky. And everything took ages, and you were really restricted on what you could do, and the pre-installed packages were quite out of date. So you got Nginx, Apache, PHP 8.1. You can upload your own snapshot or image. Got Ubuntu, Jammy 22.04, Focal 20.04, Bionic. You can also use Alma Linux, CentOS. Alma Linux is kind of, it is used in businesses instead of Red Hat. I believe it's SC Security Enhanced. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. So yeah, you just come down here and you just type a name for your server. It auto creates a slug, and then you click the big green button that says create server. So yeah, on that note, I'm going to wrap up this video, but in a future video, we will be looking at actually creating a server, deploying to the server. I'll do a run through of Python, and then we'll start with some projects looking at Django, FastAPI, Flask, and so on. And yeah, then we'll actually try and start putting it through its paces and trying to sort of push it. And I gather they actually recommend these servers for gaming as well. So definitely worth investigating that if you want to start running a gaming server. So thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon. Don't forget the link in the description. Go there, you'll get a discount. I'm using this for myself, so I'm not just advertising stuff. I know a lot of sites will just shamelessly promote bits and pieces. And if this goes well, then I may look to reduce or even remove the adverts from YouTube, but don't tell YouTube because I don't like it. Anyway, on that bombshell, thanks for watching, and yeah, see you next time.